Chani Singh and welcome back to my channel. Today again it's review time. So all the makeup artists or even people who are not makeup artists, we need one thing for sure to blend our makeup to perfection, and that is called a beauty blender. So I mean, even as makeup artists, we might have our share of best tools, be it from Sigma or MAC or Bobbi Brown or Morphe or Real Techniques, but we all own a beauty blender and we all know how important it is to have one which has the right texture. I mean, when the beauty blender was launched so many years back, I was really shocked that really, is that all they are selling? And boy, look at it, man, every makeup artist is hooked to it. I mean, even though if it's for $20, we don't think twice before owning a few. I mean, I myself own 4 of them at each go. I even have the tiny ones, I bought the pink, I bought the red, I bought the black, I bought all of them. And definitely cannot do without it. I also remember at one point I lost one of my beauty blenders, which was the last one in my stock, and I was so upset. Nevertheless, a few months back, which is almost 5 months back, I was introduced to the YBP Makeup Perfector. And what I also got to know is that this is an Indian company that has launched it, and I'm particularly very happy to help Indian brands, you know, make, I mean, if their product is good, I like to help them and give them a good word if they are seriously good. And one thing that I have to say about YBP, that their makeup perfector is absolutely fantastic. Totally love it. So this is what it also comes in a cardboard kind of box. I haven't saved it, of course. And I also, so this is the box that comes inside the cardboard box. What I like about this is also that it's perforated. And this is the original size when it is 100% dry. What I also want to show you people is that I have been using it for 5 months now. This has gone through 2 of my professional makeup courses. It has also gone through so many makeups, so many brides, so many clients. And look at it, it just, at the moment, I can only spot 2 little, you know, I mean, where it's kind of become a little bit enlarged at 2 certain area. But for a beauty blender to last you 5 months through a lot of makeups, this is a very good condition to be in, right? And another thing I like is that, I mean, the box size is relatively bigger. I'm sure all of us have faced that problem that once our beauty blender was bigger, once we wet it, putting it back into the original box was absolutely impossible. So also another thing that I want to talk about is the right way of using the YBP Makeup Perfector, and the one I have is called Lust. Apparently they also have one which is white in color. So now mostly what people do is that, you know, they usually take like a spray bottle and they'll kind of spray it and they'll tend to use it. No, I always say that first time around, make sure you either put it in running water, or you can just take a bowl full of water and dip it really well in there. Right, so once and twice. So once you soak it in water, you will see that it instantly swells up. Also remember that whenever you're squeezing it out, you know, especially if you have long nails, dig them into your beauty blender, you know. So what I also recommend is that you can like literally squeeze it between your palms, right? So make sure you do not dig your nails into it, because you will ruin your beauty blender, specifically, I mean, anyone that you are using. So, and what I like about it is that even while it is wet, and if you want to keep it back, it fits perfectly into it. Also because it's perforated, it kind of dries up, even if you like to kind of keep it back into your makeup kit. Another advantage, they've given us this little plate on top of it, which actually even works very well for any kind of foundation mixing or anything. So love the way you can store it as well. And another thing that I want to talk about is that it is latex free. free, so which kind of really works well to our advantage. Also, if I really compare it to an original beauty blender, I barely see any difference. The only difference between the original beauty blender and the YBP is that this is just a tad bit more bigger. I mean, and trust me, it'll just take you a couple of times to get used to it if you've been hooked on beauty blender. So an original beauty blender is for about $20, which is about 1300 something. And these ones are now on ybpcosmetics.com, their website, for about $9.99. And they keep having these discounts of 10% off or something. So make sure you kind of avail it during one of those times. What I also want to talk about it is that I have been using it and I absolutely love it. I am on my last original beauty blender and I don't think I am ever going to buy the original beauty blender again now that I have the YBP Makeup Perfector with me. Absolutely love it, totally recommend it, and if I had to give it marks between a 1 and 10, I give it a complete 10 out of 10. So a must buy, guys. I mean, and ditch that beauty blender and move on to the YBP Makeup Perfector.